Did you know that there are three types of pain? In 2018, the International Association for the Study of Pain, or ISP, released a new pain classification. The three types of pain are nociceptive pain, neuropathic pain, and nociplastic pain. In this video, I will explain what they mean, how do we diagnose them in clinical practice, and how we treat each one of them. So, let's talk about the three types of pain today. To understand these three types of pain, let me tell you what pain is. Pain is the alarm system of our body. It is good to have an alarm system. Some people are born without the ability to feel pain and they die at an early age. As an alarm system of a house, you install sensors for smoke, breakings, water leak, carbon monoxide all over your house. Our body has various sensors distributed everywhere. The skin is where most of the sensors are, but we also have some sensors in the internal organs. The skin has sensors to detect high temperature, low temperature, too much pressure, chemicals, and many others. All of these sensors send electrical signals to the spinal cord. The spinal cord is similar to the box on the wall where all the wires of the house alarm convey. Here in the box, you can activate the alarm, deactivate it, turn the volume up or down, give different passwords to various people in your household, and many other adjustments. This box will communicate with the central office via telephone. The main office will analyze the information coming from your house and decide to send the ambulance, the fire truck, or the police to your house. In the human body, the brain decides what to do with the information of pain. So let's study nociceptive pain. Nociceptive pain is pain caused by an injury or a disease activating the pain receptors. That's exactly what the pain system is designed to do. To alert the brain that something is causing damage to the body. Examples are bruises, sprains, burns, bone fractures, appendicitis, menstrual cramps, heart attack, kidney stones, a surgery, a medical procedure, and many other acute events to our body. In the analogy of the alarm of the house, there is a fire in the house and the central office has to send a fire truck. Or there is a burglar and the central office has to send the police. Or there is a medical emergency and the central office has to send the ambulance. This type of pain is what we call acute pain. It is short-lived, lasts a few hours or days. The body heals and the pain stops. We treat nociceptive pain with ice packs, anesthesia, transcutaneous electrical nerve stimulation, TENS, acetaminophen, anti-inflammatories, and in some cases, opioids. The second type is neuropathic pain. This type of pain is a consequence of an injury or disease of the nervous system. The nervous system communicates with and controls the whole body, sending orders and receiving information. The nervous system comprises the central, peripheral, and autonomous nerve system. The central nerve system contains the brain and the spinal cord. The brain and the spinal cord are surrounded by special membranes and they are kind of isolated from the rest of the body and protected inside very thick bones like the skull and the vertebrae. The peripheral nerve system is composed of all the nerves that exit the spinal cord. And the autonomous nerve system has some parts inside the central nerve system and some parts outside the central nerve system. The autonomous nervous system is divided into two parts, the sympathetic and the parasympathetic autonomous nervous system. When there is an injury or damage to the nervous system, this will generate a sensation that will be interpreted by the brain as pain. But this is not actually pain from nociceptor stimulation. In the analogy of the alarm system, it's like if someone cut a wire. The central alarm system will receive a signal that someone cut the wire of your house. That doesn't seem good. Maybe someone will try to invade and they disconnected the alarm from your house. So the central office will have to do something about that. You can't just go on with the alarm wires cut off. When a nerve is injured by a cut, a pressure, or a disease, it generates neuropathic pain. So the brain will detect that the wires have been cut, damaged, and the way to alert you is by creating pain. So it's a different kind of pain from nociceptive pain, because here the injury is in the alarm system itself. These injuries to the pain system can happen in the periphery, the central nervous system, or the autonomous nervous system. Examples of conditions that cause neuropathic pain are peripheral neuropathies, nerve compressions, radiculopathy, spinal cord injury, stroke, multiple sclerosis. Neuropathic pain can be acute if the injury starts abruptly, or it can slowly progress in case of a nerve compression or neuropathies, for example. The treatment for neuropathic pain is different from nociceptive pain. Neuropathic pain is treated with agents that reduce the activity of nerves and neurons. These are usually antidepressants and anticonvulsants. Opioids are sometimes combined with these drugs to increase the pain analgesic effect. But acetaminophen, anti-inflammatories, they rarely have some effect on neuropathic pain. It seems that cannabinoids, lidocaine, and ketamine, they have some benefit for neuropathic pain. Well, before I continue, let me remind you that this video is not intended to replace medical advice. It's for educational purposes only. You should contact your doctor for a proper diagnosis and treatment plan for you. In case of emergency, go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. So now, let's talk about the third type of pain, nociplastic pain. This pain is caused by neuroplasticity, or changes in the pain system that occur as a consequence of a nociceptive or neuropathic pain. The World Health Organization, in its 11th revision of the International Classification of Diseases, ICD-11, includes chronic pain as a diagnosis in its own right. It can be chronic primary and chronic secondary pain. Chronic primary pain refers to pain that exists despite complete tissue healing, or pain that has no identifiable cause. This is nociplastic pain. Chronic secondary pain occurs in association with an underlying disease, and they can be nociceptive, neuropathic, or mixed. So, what exactly is nociplastic pain? In the analogy of the pain system, it's like this. There was a fire in a house, it burned the whole kitchen, it was bad. The house appeared on the local radio and TV news. The owners were super scared, their kids were screaming in the streets, but nobody got seriously injured or died. The insurance company fixed the kitchen, and they got a new appliances and all new furniture for the kitchen. It looks much better than the old kitchen. However, the owners are still frightened by what happened. They are so afraid of this happening again that they are not using the new kitchen. In addition, the alarm office was terribly affected by this whole situation, because when the alarm was triggered, the lady who received the call at the central office was distracted. She didn't send the fire trucks right away, and this delay contributed to the whole kitchen being destroyed. She feels guilty even years after the fire has happened. She still is afraid of making that mistake again. The co-workers are having regular staff meetings to solve the situation and help her. She keeps getting panic attacks every time that there is an incoming call from a house fire. So, this is nociplastic pain. The injury has healed. The body has been restored, but the person still has fears and memories of the pain. The person is afraid of using that body part, cannot sleep at night, is constantly fatigued during the day, cannot concentrate on simple tasks, cannot work, and their life starts spiraling down. The person is afraid of making a mistake, and fear is paralyzing. Now, even the autonomous sympathetic nervous system is alert all the time. Instead of enjoying their life and accomplishing what they would like to do, they are stuck in the memory of pain. So, like the family in the house, instead of enjoying the new kitchen, they are paralyzed by fear. And like the central alarm office, instead of forgiving a mistake and retraining the staff to avoid this from happening again, they are stuck in guilt, shame, and perfectionism. The treatment of nociplastic pain involves brain retraining, mind-body therapies. I have another video that I explain various evidence-based mind-body therapies that work for chronic pain. It is very simple to retrain the brain. The person first needs to understand that the pain is coming from malfunctioning of their pain system, that the pain is real, but it's coming from the fear of pain. Once a person sees that, it's easy to erase the memory of pain. It makes me sad when I see a patient with nociplastic pain for years and nobody ever told them this. And worse, they're prescribed multiple medications that are good for nociceptive or neuropathic pain, but they do nothing to nociplastic pain. Well, in case of opioids, it can even make nociplastic pain worse. We call this opioid-induced hyperalgesia. I have another video that I explain that. So how do we diagnose these three types of pain? This is done by taking a good history of the pain, their other symptoms, how it happened, what makes it worse or better. I have another video that I teach how you can explain your pain to your doctor, and there is a worksheet that you can download for you to get all the essential details of pain before you meet with your doctor. We also need to do a mental health screening to see if there are psychological symptoms, as these are important to differentiate nociplastic pain from the other pains. We do a physical exam to look at the body parts that are affected by pain, which include a sensory examination of the pain nociceptors in the skin, an examination of the parts that hurt, and a neurological exam. And finally, we may need to order some labs and tests to find out where the pain is coming from. For example, if we suspect there is a kidney stone causing pain, we might need to order an ultrasound to see where the stone is and to confirm the diagnosis. In chronic pain clinics, it's common to see patients who have these different types of pain simultaneously. Sometimes the person may have purely an ongoing nociceptive pain. Inflammation, for example. This is common in arthritis. But some people will develop an exaggerated fear of pain, and that fear will paralyze them. And there are cases of purely nociplastic pain. An example is fibromyalgia. I have another video that I explain in more details what fibromyalgia is, and another video that I explain why some people have fibromyalgia, what predispose a person to have developed fibromyalgia, or in other words, risk factors that put a person at a higher risk of developing nociplastic pain. The good news about nociplastic pain is that it's treatable and the results are incredibly satisfying. The brain is plastic, which means that the brain can heal itself. We can teach the brain to think differently, to not be afraid of pain and let go of guilt, shame, and perfectionism. I have seen patients who overcame their nociplastic pain with very simple and quick mind-body therapies. Many people are pain-free today. Others still have some residual nociceptive or neuropathic pain, but they tell me that these pains are easier to manage and they are not debilitated by them. What was very debilitating was the fear they had from pain, which is now gone. They don't fear pain anymore. They stopped pain medications. They practice self-compassion. They meditate. They exercise regularly, and they're able to enjoy their lives and fulfill their dreams. Well, if you like this video, press the thumbs up here. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and turn on the notifications button and watch my next video here. Goodbye.